Hello everyone, welcome to the Smarty Techie. For now, for today's topic, we will be learning how to connect an R application to the MongoDB instances, but we will connect this application using Java language. So if you want to connect these things, if you want to connect Mongo using your on language, for example python.net, you can connect using these string URI format which has been given in this document. But some methods are different, as we are not going to, for now we are not going to connect using XML format. We will be using our some Java functions given by Spring MongoDB data. So if you are using any other language, please check the drivers options and the different functions to use in your applications. Before go on, let's proceed on our today's topic. So here is a document over at connection string URI format, which also specify that how to connect between application and MongoDB instances. There are number of formats. In Java, if you are using Spring, you can connect it using spring.xml file, then using Mongo template, Mongo client options, there are number of options. And also we can connect using the Mongo functions given by the Spring MongoDB data, Spring data. So in today's topic, but we are not going to use the XML format. We will use the Java functions given by Spring. So let's get started on this. And in this, you can find there are number of options that standalone, replica set, and sharded cluster. Standalone is the single server application, single MongoDB server application. If you are using your application and there is only one server, only one host to connect to the MongoDB, so you can use the this option. And if you have using your replica option for connecting to the Mongo, then you can go with this options. We will be doing the both options one by one. Firstly, we will get started with the standalone. This is the sharded cluster. If your Mongo is a sharded cluster, you can go with this option. So here is a URI format. In this format, there are number of components. For firstly is a MongoDB that we are, you can check here. This is a required prefix to identify that this is a string in the standard connection format. So you have to it is must to give in a in your URI format. So this is a MongoDB, then is a colon, then is a double slash. This is a fake prefix. After this, this is your host name. In our case, it will be localhost. And if you have any IP, you can give here the IP as well. For example, 101.28.32.16. You can give any of the IPs if you wanted to connect. Then there is a colon, then is a port. So port and host is separated by the colon option. Then after port there is a slash, then after slash there is a database name. Now if you have the username and password 2 to connect to your DB in your Mongo instances, then you have to give, before giving any host or port, you have to give your username and password. The example given here is MongoDB, this is a prefix. Then MyDB reader, this is a username, colon, this is a password. So username and password is separated by colon, then password and host is separated by @ option. Then this is the same as before, colon, port number, slash, admin. If you have a username and your username is given to any specific database, then you have to replace this admin with your database name. If you are not giving any database, it will by default going to connect to your admin. And For example, if your username is not connected to that database given here like admin, then it will give you the exception that not authorized. In this document you can find number of components here, given host, port, database and options here. This is a connection options you want to give during connecting your application. Number of options may be containing your read preferences, your replica set names, your connection timeout option, your socket timeout option. There are number of options for the pool connections, for the read preferences, for the auth mechanisms, for auth source. We will be using it one by one, not all of them, but giving some example on it I will be using in our application. So firstly we will check with our let's test with some small example on it. I have created an, so let's remove this. I have created in class Mongo contest, and we will be doing in public static void main function only to demonstrate to you. In other video we will be using in our full example application controller service, then DAO, which will be connected to the Mongo application. So for now we are using the URI format, then in next video in our application we will be using the builder options which has been given by the Spring database. Before using any MongoDB functions, you have to give your dependencies in pom.xml. In pom.xml dependency which I have given using a Spring Data MongoDB, and the version of it is 2.0.2 release. So before going or before proceeding with any Mongo function, you have to provide this dependency in your pom.xml function. If you are not using any Maven project, please download the jar file to use it. So this is a dependency and this is the version which I am using now. So let's start with this. Firstly we need to create our URI. So in Java, if you are not using XML format, then we will be creating here only. So firstly you need to create Mongo client URI equals to Mongo client URI equals to new Mongo client URI, and you will be giving your URI format. Let's copy it from here. As this is a prefix, we will not change it, but in replace of this host name we will use our local host, as we are going to connect to the local host Mongo. Maybe you have your IP host, so you can give it 10.70.30.21, and then here is a port. This is a default port. If your Mongo application is running on another port, please specify here. Maybe your port is running, your Mongo is running on this port, so please specify the port name here. I am running my Mongo application on the default port, so we will be using here 27017, and here is a database name. As I have I am not using any username and password to connecting to the Mongo, so I can give here admin database. This is a localhost. Now we will be creating a Mongo client. this Mongo client has been given our URI, so that this client will be connecting to this MongoDB only, which is our localhost 27017 port. So this Mongo client is our Mongo client which is connecting to the MongoDB instance which is running in our local host. Using this client, we can get our database, any database which you have already defined in your system. So Mongo client dot, you can check their number of options which has been given here. I want to fetch my database, or I'm giving here the get database, and give, and you have to give your database name. My database name is Smarty Techie. This will be a Mongo database type. So here we have got our database, and using database we can get any collection which I have defined in our database. So Mongo collection which is of document type. Equals to db dot get collection. My collection name will be this. So you can check, this is my local host MongoDB. My data name base is Smarty Techie, and my collection name is subscribers list. Collection. Okay, this is not a swing type of document. This document is our Spring MongoDB document. This document will be org.json. So here is a client, here is our DB, and here is our collection. And in collection you can perform a number of operation which you can use here. For example, in here we are using find, so you can use find option to collection dot. So here is number of options given: aggregate, bulk write count, create index, delete, testing, find. There's number of options, the number of queries you can run here, you can also run here. So collection dot find, and this will be so here is a client, here is a DB, here it is collection, and here is a document. It will be same as this query, subscriber list dot find. For example, you want to get only one, you can use the limit 2. So what will it do? It will find the collection which will be containing only one document. So you can give number of options here. Next, let's print this for, we want to print the document which we have got here. So document document doc sysout document. So what we have done here is getting the URI option, URI format, then use this URI format in our creating Mongo client connection. And by after creating the client, we are getting our database, and then from database we are getting our collection. Then using collection, they are by using different number of queries. I am using the find option. So from collection, I want to find all the document containing in this. And after getting the document, we are iterating over it to print the document which we got from our collection. After using all this operation, do not forget to close the connection. Okay. Let's run our application. Okay, here is a connection opening socket connection refuse. It is giving this exception as I haven't started my MongoDB instance. So service MongoD start. As before connecting to any Mongo, it should be running on your host. So my host is localhost, so I have to firstly run in my application in my localhost system. So it should be started now. So here it is running, so I can connect to now I can connect to my MongoDB service. Java application. My database name is Smarty. Thank you. So it should be running now. Okay, here it printed my document which it find in my application, which it find in my localhost system on which my MongoDB instance is running. So if you want to verify, you can check here. Here is my subscriber list. I'm running this, so you can check there are only three documents. So it's printing my three document which it find in my MongoDB localhost system. So it's all about how to connect our MongoDB instance and our application using in Java using URI format. In another video we will check it out how to connect our MongoDB instance from our application using the MongoDB client builder options given by the Spring Data MongoDB. So and we will check out number of options which has been given. For example, it has been given here connection string options. Number of options is given. We will check how we are using in our application. So do not forget to subscribe my channel and like my videos if you like it. And we will check out another topic in another video. So bye bye, take care.